Hello guys, what's going on? Lucifer Pen here, and I'm back with another Clash of Clans video. And in today's video guys, as you can see on the screen, we have a war between Three Strikes F against Damned Souls, both level 15 clans, and this was actually an NDL war. And as you can see on the screen guys, Three Strikes F did come out of the victory by 12 stars, which is pretty impressive in an NDL war. So we're going to be looking at some of their best attacks today and seeing how they did. So they did 3-star every single base, apart from this base over here, which is number 7. They did a decent attack on that, and they were close to getting a perfect war. You see by the percentage, they were really close, 99.36% for them, and a little bit more, and they would have got that, obviously. Just needed 3-star base for the perfect war. But let's have a look at some of their attacks. So, we're going to start off on the Town Hall 11 gameplay, because at the moment, there is no Town Hall 12s in NDL, and let's see how Boog, or Bog, comes in here and does it. So, this was a fresh hit, I believe. He does hit a Baby Dragon. The Baby Dragon does hit an M, I know, which is kind of unlucky. And he's coming in with a Queen Walk, got a Pekka, and he's got some Bowlers and Witches, and also a Golem in the Arm Camp as well. So I saw this stack, and I was pretty interested to see how the Pekkas came into this, because it is a pretty much max channel 11 on defense, apart from the Wolves, and he is a max channel 11 on offense. So let's see how he does. So he's got a Queen Walk here for the funnel, going to be popping the ability early, because he is late on the poison, kind of unlucky there. And he's got Golem over here to funnel, and then he's got some Bowlers and Witches around the outside to funnel even more. So he comes in with the Siege Machine in the middle, which is going to be breaking through the wall and making a funnel, making all those troops walk into the base, like the Pekkas, the Bowlers. He's not going to Witches in the core, but he does have all three heroes as well, and it is only a multi-inferno, which is going to be attacking him. So the healers are going to be healing everything up, and he does have a heal spell there as well in case he needs it, and he's going to be dropping the jump spell in just a moment to get through the base. So at this moment, there is not too many troops left in the outside of the base. There is only a couple of Witches, but there is quite a lot of troops in the core. Loads of Bowlers, still two Pekkas, I believe. Queen, King, Grand Warden, King's Ability as well. Drops the jump spell in now. Still got a healer as well, healing up some of these troops. And the Queen does go down, sadly. She does split from the kill squad, but it doesn't really matter. She did what's needed. She took down both multi-dog Inferno Towers, and at this point, he has three Pekkas left up, I believe. About five Bowlers, three Witches, and he's even got a Suicide Bowler in the middle, which is going to be doing some damage to this Wizard Tower and the Arch Tower as well. So yeah, pretty much just a 3-star here, cleaning up with all these Bowlers and the healers, making sure he's going to get the 3-star. Still got the King's Ability, he's going to be using that in a moment, so he doesn't run out of time, because this was a pretty close attack on time, I believe, and that is going to be a 3-star. Once the King does use the ability, goes on the base, and that's going to be it. So good. It's a really good attack there from his 3-strikes, and we're going to be moving down to the next one, which is number 6, which is Johnny 2-star coming in with a 10v10, I believe. So I saw this attack as well, and I was so confused how he was going to get the Queen, because he didn't have a Skeleton spell. I thought that could have been an idea, because there isn't too much splash around it. But he comes in here with the Siege Machine. Now, I have seen this done at Town Hall 11 and 12, but not at Town Hall 10. So let's see how he does it. So he drops in some minions to funnel here, and he's got some Wizards as well. Siege Machine is going to be going to 40 Town Hall, obviously, which means it's going to be going through this compartment over here. And I was wondering if he had Varrox inside it, because he isn't dropping the Siege Machine with the Queen Walk, but he does a really cool strategy here. So once the Siege Machine gets through the base, going to be damaging the Wizard Tower, which is a pretty good thing, because he does have balloons inside it, guys. Wizard Tower's down, and here comes the Haste Spell for all these balloons. Going to be taking down one Arch Tower, two Arch Tower, a three Arch Tower, and the Expo, and I believe the other Expo as well. So super high value there for a Siege Machine, basically a Clan Castle and a one Haste Spell, and he even gets the CC Lure here, which was a Lava Hound and a Balloon, but the Queen Walk does take it down. So really nice job here to Johnny, going to be coming in with this attack strategy, and then he's still got to get the Queen though before he does drop his Hogs. So 25 Hogs, still got a Rage, and still got a Heal Spell as well. He's still got three Heal Spells actually, if he needs them for the Hog Riders, but he's going to be making a funnel with his King. He's going to need to pop the Queen's Ability in a moment, because he is fighting the King. No, actually the King doesn't go down, so that's all good. And here comes the Queen, gonna be walking around the base now, gonna be getting a bomb tower as well, and that's super high value here. Got a little Wizard, got a little Giant down there to distract, and he's gonna be starting with his Hogs, because at this point he knows the enemy Queen is gonna go down, because his Queen is heading into the base. And look at the value, guys, his Queen Walk's got, it's got so much value here, and the Hogs aren't even really needed too much. Obviously doesn't need them, but not really, doesn't really need 25, and definitely doesn't need 3 heal spells. So basically going to be swagging a heal on these last couple defenses up the top, and that is going to be the 3-star, guys. Also got some cleanup Hogs, swagging 4 Hogs just for the cleanup if he does need them. Here they go, dropping them down the bottom on these collectors and all the build huts and all the trash that's left in the base. And that's going to be a freestyle hit for Jolly. So really nice attack. I love the use of the siege machine there. Really unique, and I haven't seen that done before at Town Hall 10, but that is definitely an idea to consider when I'm doing my attacks and when my clanmates are doing our attacks. So let's see another attack here, a little bit more simple attack. He's got a hog rooker and he's going to be making a funnel from the top just to get the troops in the base, and then he's going to be trying to take down the queen, king, the bomb towers and the CC. So once he does that, he's going to be coming in with the hogs and heels. So let's see how he does it. So siege machine at the top with some wizards and baby dragons to funnel. Got some bowlers, obviously he needs them for the kill squad. And the siege machine does get through the wall, even though it was nerfed. It does do its damage at Town Hall 10. And here comes a golem in the siege machine, because there is no single target infernos around this section of the base. So dropping a rage spell in just a moment to help get through the base here. And here comes a rage. And at this point, only bomb towers are really left that can damage his troops. And here comes the queen. So queen's going to go down pretty simply to the enemy queen, to the attacking queen. And that is going to be the freestyle pretty much, because all he's got to do now is kill the clan castle and then drop in his hogs, and that's pretty much a freestyle. So let's see how he does it. So queen's ability gonna need to be used because she is locked on by the single target inferno. Good hog deployment there, making sure the hogs don't path out of the base, and he's gonna be dropping in a heal spell quite late here. I maybe would drop one earlier because he does have four, but here comes a heal. So he's got all his hogs in now at this point. Golem is even up here tanking, which he's probably gonna die to a single target inferno, but he does trigger a bomb, which is pretty good. And he's got his cleanup wizards around the edge also. So he's got two heals left up now and probably about 13, no, even more than that. He's probably got like 20 hogs left as well. And that is going to be pretty much an overkill here. Drops in the heal really early just to make sure his hogs don't die to any giant bombs. And he's going in with the final heal spell in just a moment here for these back end defenses and that giant bomb. He also has some skeletons, but he does have poison for that. Pretty much got everything covered here, and he's still got the cleanup doing work on the outside, so it's going to be a freestyle. Only thing that could stop him is time, but he does get a really nice hog split here. Some hogs go to town hall, some could go to the elixir storage, and that's a really good attack here by RGE, who was actually in our first video when we did a recap on freestrike's F as well. So let's move down to number 11 now. It's a 9v9, I believe. Let's see how he does it. So he's coming in here with a go baby attack. Now what this is a town hall 9 attack strategy where you basically use a gobo laloon. But instead of lava hounds, you use a baby dragon at the end and a couple of baby dragons at the end to get the remaining defenses. So let's see how he does it here. Now he's got two jump spells here, which is pretty interesting. Obviously no war wreckers at Town Hall 9. So let's see how Opala does actually do it. So he's got a rage spell for the kills, got CC ball. He's also got a triple golem here, guys, which is pretty insane. I don't know if I would have a three, but it did work out. Let's see how he does it. He's got some wizards. They do die to a giant bomb, which is kind of sad. Loads of CC over there with a balloon, I believe, or might have been a hog rider. I'm not too sure. I didn't really catch that. And here comes the CC. Obviously going to die to a poison. And a queen. Also got some wizards in there helping out. The defending queen does actually go down, which is awesome. The king manages to break through the wall, take her down. And at this point, guys, overkill. He doesn't really need the baby dragons. Still got 9 baby dragons left alive, I believe. Or maybe he's got about 8, but something like that. And he's still got the queen. The queen's ability. He's still got bowlers. And still got a golem tanking up the top. And overkilling this base, guys. Still swagging the queen ability. He doesn't even need it yet. Going to be using it in a moment because these Teslas are locked on. Going to be using it now. And at this point, guys, wizard towers left. Really not going to do much to these baby dragons. The only thing that could stop him is traps. But he does have balloons. And look at that, guys. He uses the balloon to secure this trap up here. Make sure it doesn't hit a baby dragon. And the king is going to go down to these baby dragons, keeping the queen alive, I believe. And the queen's going to help in cleanup. So basically, got about all his baby dragons left alive in his raid. And that, wait, does he actually have all? Yeah, I believe he has all his baby dragons left alive in his raid. Didn't lose a single one here to traps or anything. So really good job here to Opella from Freestrikes F. So really good here. And let's move on to the next Town 9 attack, which is number 14, which I believe is a dragon attack. Let's see how it's done by Uday here. And no, okay, this is actually a Gobo Lalo. The next one is a dragon attack, and that is what we're going to be looking at. So a couple guys did ask for a Tunnel 9 Gobo Lalo, and here it is, guys. Putting it in the video for you because this kill squad is massive here. Does a really good job, and he drops his bowlers over on this build hut. Really interesting deployment here. I maybe would have dropped them on the army camp, but it does work. And let's see how he goes. So he's got the double golem here and some wizards for funneling, and he's got the jump spell as well, making all his troops head into the base. He's got the golems moving in, bowlers, king, queen, and it sort of poisons as well. 40s defending troops, like the Imperial Dragon, and it also hits the Queen. So really good job there. And at this point, he has a really good kill squad going here. Nothing walks around in the kill squad here, and he's going to be taking down the 3 air defenses with the kill squad, the CC, the Queen, and almost getting a 4th as well. So really nice attack here from Alday, and he's going to be starting his Lalo portion from the right hand side here with a couple haste spells just to make sure nothing does actually get too far behind and nothing does die to a wizard tower. So dropping them haste spells, just make sure the balloons take the wizard towers down early. And there is a sweeper here, so he does need to drop them in. Like now, he's going to be dropping one, just make sure they do get through the defenses. Still got the king, still got the queen, still got a haste spell, still got a lava hound, and he's got some cleanup troops here. Late on the cleanup, but he does have enough troops to get through this base. The balloons do split. And he's still got heroes up, which is going to be helping with the cleanup also. So good job here to Alday. Really nice Gobo Lalo and great kill squad here. Definitely getting as much value as he wanted and probably even a bit more. Don't know if he expected to get 3 air defenses, but he did a great job here. So let's move on to the final attack, guys, which is a dragon attack on number 17. So area here coming in with the dragon attack. Epic dragon attack here with the buff lightnings. Let's see how she does it. So she comes in with a quake spell up here. And then the lightning's behind. Going to be taking down all these buildings up here. Obviously not damaging the storage, but it doesn't need the storage to go down in this attack. So it comes in with the heroes at the bottom. Going to be taking down the air defense. Now the reason this attack works so well is because with the kill squad and the lightning, you can actually get 3 air defenses in this attack. And at that point, there's not really a lot that can stop these dragons, especially when you have the electric dragon in the CC like she is bringing in this attack. So let's see how she does it. Dropping in the baby dragon here to follow. Make sure the queen does go to the air defense. And that is exactly what's going to happen. King is going to be taking down some trash. And it's going to be a really good start here. Going to get a Tesla as well. And pretty much the only thing that could stop him at this point is the queen. And the 1 air defense left up. But she does have a lava hound here tanking the queen and the air defense, which is awesome. Also got the electric dragon doing some damage in the middle of the base. Obviously tanking as well because the electric dragon has a ton of hit points, still got the queen up on the outside as well. And no cleanup in this attack. Maybe would have bought a couple minions over here. But the dragons are luckily going to go and take that down. So Electro Dragon doing its thing in the middle. Going to be on its own, getting attacked by the Expo, Arch Tower and the Wizard Towers. But it's all good. And even the traps. But the Electro Dragon is losing like 0 health, guys. That's insane how much health the Electro Dragon has. So overpowered at these lower town hall levels. Pretty much the only thing that can stop him is time, but the electric dragon is hitting multiple buildings at once, so time is not really a factor, and she's got the dragons on the other side of the base doing damage as well. So really good attack here from Area. Again, really good war from 3 Strikes F, crushing in this NDL war and beating the other team, Damn Souls, by 12 starts. So really good attacks and war again. Can't believe how amazing they've done this one. Almost getting a perfect war in NDL, which is just insane, guys. Shout out to 3 Strikes F. And if you want to join some of the clans that I'm featuring in these videos, I will leave a link down below to recruitment if you want to do sign up. They do take max bases, so try to be almost maxed. And obviously they are a league clan, guys. So if you want to go ahead and try and apply, link is going to be down below. And I'll see you next time. Peace out.